Hey guys, Kevin71 here, and this is the special video I've been talking about building up to. So, I have two cameos in it and all that, but first off, the person who made this possible, Ken6275, if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have had this thing, and yeah, I would have never have gotten one probably. This thing I'm going to show you, I've wanted one for a very long time, ever since back in the 90s when I saw one, but they're very expensive, and not many people then, or even now, because they're even more now, could afford these. The only reason I was able to get it is because he actually, he let me have it for free. He was willing to send it to me for free because it basically doesn't work right now, but it can be fixed to work. He tried to mod it and it didn't work out, so he thought, it's not doing him any good, so, let me have it. I asked him. I found out about that he had it through SNK Neo Geo Man, who I was talking to on the Skype a lot, and I just kept on mentioning I wanted one of these always, even if it was broken or anything like that. So he was surprised I even knew about the thing, which is true because there's not many people that know about it, these things that know about it or even talk about it or anything like that. So, and that's it. So now I'm going to show you what it is. This is not like a normal one. This is not an American one. This is not a Japanese one. I'll tell you what it is. Some of you seeing it, you might recognize the characters on it, but I'll tell you what it is. I recognized it immediately, and even he was surprised that I figured out what it was, but that's just because I like Asian stuff, so I can recognize characters from different languages, from different Asian cultures. So, like I said, it doesn't work, but it can be fixed to work. So keep that in mind. No, I didn't spend like $1,000 or anything. Like I said, he gave it to me for free. Yes. And this is what I was talking about. You see that? Wait for it to focus. If it's going to. There you go. See what it says above Neo Geo? That's what gives it away. Can you guess which Asian culture this is from? You'll know soon enough. So yes, this is a AES. For those of you who don't know, back in the 90s, this thing retailed for $649. That is US, the American. They sold this in two different versions, the gold and the silver. The gold came with two controllers, which I don't have any controllers, but that's no big deal. I gotta get the thing working, first of all. I'm not really worried about that. I don't have a memory card either, but that's something else. You'll see that. The thing itself is very light, very, even though despite its size, it's extremely light. I took the screws out so I could show you shady inside too. Notice how big the cartridge slot is. The cartridges for this thing are massive. They're as big as my head. Cost a lot too. No one, next to no one had this back then. A lot of people don't have it now either because they don't know about it, they're not interested in it, about it, they don't care about it, or they just can't afford it. So, the other thing and different about this is, well, it's made by SNK, an arcade company. It says Vic A. I'll go into that more. The thing itself has two cartridge things on the front, has a volume slider, much like the Model 1 Genesis. In fact, I should have probably brought that over here, just as size comparison. In fact, I think I might. Hold on. Okay, so I got two I can compare it to. The PlayStation and the Model 1 Genesis. First, we'll do it compared to the PlayStation. Why not? I don't have any games, so I can't compare the size of the cartridges. But you can see from the size of this how big it is compared to like a Genesis one, which are very tiny. Trying to find a way to do this as my throat's bothering me. So there's the thing itself, the Neo Geo, which is basically an arcade machine. Here's a PlayStation compared to it. PlayStation, Neo Geo. You can see that the PlayStation is almost kind of as big as it. But not really. But here's probably the best one. It's all dusty because I haven't played it in about a week. Model 1 Genesis. Trying to. Yeah, you can see there. It's probably not the best way to do it. But as I was saying, like the volume thing, see, this has a volume thing too. And it slides up and it has the thing there. Just like this. Although I've never used the headphone thing on this, but it works the same way. So you have the same slider, you have two cartridge ports on it. The power switch is over here. And this is for the memory card. So, it's not necessary, but it's a good thing to have. So, By the way, this is worn off from age, but where it says Neo Geo and has the characters here, that was originally gold, so if I get to that point and I find a way and I can find the correct color, I'm going to touch it up, fix it, you know. The reason I call it AES is because that's basically what a lot of people call it, but a lot of people like me, we just usually call it Neo Geo, Advanced Entertainment System. That's what the AES stands for. So, have you been able to guess what where this is from? It's a Korean one, yes. And from what I was told by Ken and what I read the other day, these are not common. A lot of people think the American one or whatever is rare. Supposedly, this one is actually more uncommon. VicA is actually the company that distributed it in Korea. And you would have figured this out anyway when I showed you the back. It doesn't have a serial number, which is strange. There you go there. Uses 8 watts VicA Neo Geo. This is still a real AES made by SNK. As you can see there, it says VicA Corporation made in Korea. SNK made in Korea. This is probably the thing that makes it the most interesting as I go to the wrong side. This is really cool here. A lot of it's worn off. It says Myohyuna Electronics. I don't know how to pronounce it because I'm not Korean. I don't know any words in Korean. And you can see there it has all the information about it, the power and crap like that. I already took the screws out so I could show you the inside. At first, I was very afraid to take this thing apart. I have a couple people behind the scenes that are helping me out figure like what to do, how to fix this and all that. Like I said, I got it from Ken. SNK Neo Geo Man told me about it. And there's another person, MC Pentland, or Marty. He's the one that's actually, I've been asking him things about, like, what about this and that, you know, thing with it. It doesn't work right now. What happened was Ken was trying to do a mod to it, which involves the LED light. Basically, you take the reset button off, you Dremel this out, and you can make the light appear through there so you know if the thing's on. Because when this works, there actually is a light that turns on, obviously this thing, but you can't see it. So what the mod does is so you can see it, but apparently he was drinking or something like that and he messed it up, so whatever. Worked out for me in the end. I finally have one of these after all these years. As I've said, I don't even care if it doesn't work, and I never am able to fix it. I'm just happy enough I have one. It means enough to me that I just have one, so I don't really know if he understands exactly how much I appreciate him doing this for me. Of course, I was also him that told me about it. This is what it looks like. It is very much like an arcade machine. Let me tell you that there's so many chips on here. Most of them say Sony. Like right there. Sony, Yamaha. I don't know if I'm right about this, but I think this is the main brain. It says SNK Corp on it. If it'll focus on it, there you go. And all this kind of stuff. There's the memory card. This video is going to be kind of long. It's just the way it is. All those capacitors. That's probably my favorite looking thing in here, this, whatever that's called. The reset button, which is actually very easy to take off, as you saw. This is something I found out, though, the other night when I took it apart. The cart, I'm trying to see around it. This cartridge, whatever these are called, I don't know the exact name of the thing you stick the cartridge in, but on this side here, if I can move my hands around, I'm not good at this kind of thing. Right there where my finger is at the end, there's actually pins that are either broken or missing or bent. I could see it right now as I'm looking at it, so before I do, if I did anything else, I'd have to fix that or take it out or somehow to replace it, because it's just not going to work otherwise. It'll probably scratch up the contacts on the games. And for those of you who don't know, the games can run anywhere from like $200, there's some that are cheaper, to the most expensive one, which is Metal Slug, which goes for like $2,000. Although there is one they only made free of called Aerial Fighters Free, which went for $35,000, and there's only two of them in existence, so yeah. By the way, for those of you who might be familiar or have heard of the MVS, we'll talk about that soon. That's actually what one of the people I had to do a cameo for. He's got one and he's going to show it. Another person has the MVS arcade cabinet. So yeah, there's a reason why most people go for the MVS over this thing. It's cheaper. You have the same games. Metal Slug 4 for the AES is the same game as it is for the MVS, but it's cheaper and the cartridge is a different size, but you'll see that. So basically what needs to be done with this in order for it to work, I need to find out which IC is burned out. I don't know how to do that because I'm not good with technical stuff like that, which is why I might actually just leave it in the current condition it's in, because I'm not good at that. This is something special. I was talking to SNK Neo Geo Man. He's never seen or heard of a Korean one. Those characters on there threw him off really good. Ken was surprised I knew what it was, but like I said, I recognize the characters on it. So this makes it even more special than it normally would be, and I like that it is. It makes it more unique. So I'd have to find out which IC is burned out, which I don't know how to do. I have a digital multimeter, maybe that's how you do it, I don't know. The LED thing has to be replaced, which that shouldn't be that hard. I could probably handle that. This thing needs to be taken off and replaced somehow, if it's even possible. I looked, I couldn't find any on the internet. I don't even know what this part's called. I actually took all the four screws out before I did this, just to see. I can't even pull it out. It's still connected somehow. So yeah. So that's what this thing looks like on the inside. Seven screws hold it in, all about seven. So yeah, I did that pre ahead of time, so that way I don't have to screw around and waste time. So yeah, that's basically what it comes down to. Big ass reset button there. This is actually my favorite console ever made. So this is the thing I've been like, anytime I was talking to someone, I mentioned something, the common thing I alluded to, like I said, this is it. I didn't want to give it away until I had this. By the way, this video is also kind of the start of a series I want to do on this thing, talk about it, give it more exposure, because not many people talk about it. I already told them about it. They thought it was a very good idea. So from time to time, I might have them do something in it. So.
Hey YouTube, it's the SNK Neo Geo Man. I was asked by Kit171 to talk a little bit about the Neo Geo. And as you can see right here, this is my Neo Geo, and it is the US version. I'll pan in right real close so you can see. You can see the gold lettering. Now, as you can see right here, it says Advanced Entertainment System. But every time people refer to the console, they always call it the AES. So if you ever hear that, that's where it comes from. See a little bit of the corners. All right, show you the back. See right there is my serial number. Vents, feet on the back. Okay. All right, let me show you what a game looks like. Right here is the US version of Samurai Showdown. As you can see, you got the vents in the back, really cool sticker. Show you the box. Great, great game. Was the first weapons fighter. Okay, show you what it looks like inside. As you can see right here, the manual and the baggie that comes with it. And eventually these trays or these boxes changed in 1995 because these had a habit of cracking. So they decided to change it, plus here would rip. So they went with a different design. They call it the snap lock boxes, which are way, way better. Okay, I'm going to show you what the game looks like inside the system. These cartridges are massive. It's kind of hard to tell looking on camera, but these cartridges are really big. I don't have a Sega Genesis or Super Nintendo to actually compare, but take my word for it, it's really, really big. As you can see it right there, this is how it sits in the system, real nice. Looks almost like a tombstone. Okay. Really good system. Problem with it is it's just the price. And this system I've had since 1994. It's one of the first games I got with it. It's a great system. I think it's my all-time favorite. That's why I have my YouTube page dedicated to it. But it was out of a lot of reach for people because people just could not afford to pay for it. Like I said, I've had mine since 1994. I sold all my Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis, Game Boy, whatever I had at the time to get this system, because to me, this was the ultimate system in the 2D era. Right here is my consoleized MVS. Basically, the MVS is the arcade, which stands for multi-video system. This is the CMVS, which is consoleized. It's basically taking the arcade board and being able to play it on your television. Now, the arcade boards could either be one slot, two slot, four slot, or six slot. As you can see, it's two slot. And the reason why people go towards the consoleized NVS is because games such as Waku Waku 7, which, if you look on eBay, starts at $400. I got this game for approximately $60. So, even though a lot of times the consoleized versions, the consoleized systems themselves are kind of a bit pricey, it's still worth being able to play. Right here is my consoleized MVS. Basically, the MVS is the arcade, which stands for multi-video system. This is the CMVS, which is consoleized. It's basically taking the arcade board and being able to play it on your television. Now, I'm going to show you that you can't play these games on this system. Even though they're the same boards, same everything, you can't play these games on there, and you can't play the MVS games on here. And I'll show you why. As you can see right here, I have it lined up. Now, as you can see, this is the AES, the home version. This is the MVS, the arcade version. Now, the one noticeable thing you'll see is the board size. These boards are much longer than these boards. And the purpose was is to keep the arcade operators from purchasing the AES game, which would range anywhere from $200 to $300. The MVS games could go $500 and up. So they changed the boards, making sure the arcade operator wouldn't buy the cheaper home version and put it into the arcade unit. So basically that's it. And if you notice too, they both have two boards, and the purpose of the two boards is to separate graphics and sound, which making graphics and sound a lot cleaner, because since they don't have to try and fit it onto one board. Also, a Neo Geo First is the memory card. Now, most people might think that the memory card was by PlayStation. No, this is the system that actually had the first memory card. And of course, the memory card save your high scores, your data. You could also use this memory card to go to the arcade and be able to play a game, save your high scores, your data, whatever it may be, or where you left off. And if you had the same game at home, you could actually go home and whatever data you left off in the arcade, you could actually continue there. I don't see why, because if you have the game at home, why would you go to the arcade and play the same thing? And it doesn't make any sense unless you want to verse somebody in the arcade.
So there you go. Thank you, Sal, for recording that. I asked them both, and they volunteered to do it. You know, I just asked them, would you want to do this, be part of it? You know. So what you saw there was the American version of Neo Geo. You saw that the letters are gold, which is what this usually it used to have before it worn off. Working on the memory card sticking out of there, and with the cartridges, look out. Samurai Showdown is actually one of my favorite games on the thing. See how big those cartridges are when you stick it in the thing, and the MVS itself. His MVS, even though it's purple, it looks different than other ones. That's a homemade one, basically. So now we are going to go to Marty MC Pentland, and we're going to see the MVS arcade cabinet, which is probably what most people might be familiar with. It's what I first used. And then we will wrap this up. It's a long video, but it's a special video. Okay, what we have here is what I asked MC Pentland Marty to record for me, was his MVS arcade cabinet. It's demoing two games, Mark of the Wolves and, I forgot, Breaker's Revenge 2. I probably like the Mark of the Wolves better. I don't know, maybe it's just me. Just the look of it or anything. As you can see here, this is probably what most people are familiar with the MVS arcade cabinet. It's, yeah, it's the most, what most people probably have used because they couldn't afford the AES or anything like that, unless you have the consoleized MVS, which is basically the same thing. The consoleized MVS is this, only in a small form. There's the coin things and all that. This is in very good condition. You can see here on the side, Neo Geo, MVS, SNK, of course, the company made it. Here's MVS cartridges. Waku Waku 7, of which SNK Neo Geo 1 just got not long ago, after it was hung up in Mexico for a long while. And here's underneath the control panel. It's pretty much what you expect in an arcade machine. And there's the inside of it. And that's the MVS itself. Like I said, it's basically the same thing as like what you saw that purple one is SNK Neo Geo Man has. It's the same thing, only this is just the JAMA arcade board, so that one has two. It kind of looks like the same as in the inside of my AES, slightly bigger. It's basically the same thing. And there's Breaker's Revenge too. Metal Slug X panel thing there, explaining things, isn't one of the games that are being showed, so thanks Marty for recording this.
Okay, so yeah, that's really about it. It's kind of like a pickup video, but really it's not. This is basically like the culmination of something I've always wanted my entire life, but I could never have due to money and just never being able to find one. You do not see these things in person, you don't see the games in person. You're more likely to see the games in person than you are the thing itself, you know. So, yeah, after all this time, I finally have one. Like I said, it doesn't matter to me that the thing doesn't work or anything like that. I could fix it and it'll work if I could figure out how to do it, or just not do it, you know, whatever. So, yeah, I don't know what else to say. Yeah, I said it was a special video, which it is, but, you know, I didn't mean special as in, like, I'm going to have explosion effects or anything like that, you know. It's more special to me, I guess, because, you know, after all this time, I finally have it. So, yeah, I don't know what else to say. Thanks to all three of you, again, for sending me the thing and being nice enough to let me have it for free, even though I offered to pay something for it, you know. SNK Neo Geo Man for recording his part, and tell me that Ken had this, and also for... You know, I'm talking to him all the time, asking him things about that and all that kind of stuff. And Marty MC Pentland for recording his MVS arcade cabinet, because that's one of the reasons I asked those two for those kind of things, because I don't have none of this kind of stuff, you know, I don't have any games for this, you know. So, you know, what else can I say? Check them out. I'll have their description, I'll have their channel links in the bottom for Ken, SNK, Neo Geo Man, and MC Pentland. They're all big into Neo Geo, just like I am. I just don't have anything for it other than the thing itself, so... I don't really know what else to say. I'll probably start the series thing on this probably next week. I don't know exactly when it's going to be, how often. It'll probably be once a week or something like that, maybe every 2 weeks, I don't know. And anytime they're willing or want to, I'll get them in on it, or maybe even someone else. All depends. So, I hope you guys liked it and you learned something about this, if you never heard about this thing before, you never seen it. So, now you all know what my favorite console is, above all, even more than the Genesis. The Genesis is probably actually number one for ones you can afford and actually get. But, absolute number one, it's this thing. Because I just love arcade games, I love Metal Slug stuff, I love Samurai Showdown, King of Fighters is great. I just love this thing. So... Thanks for watching. I will see you next time. Take care.